Hi everybody, it's Eugene Lee Show. I thought I would do another little video here to look at CloudCompare's subsampling features. And a lot of people don't realize that you can make really nice even point clouds with CloudCompare. And this subsampling feature is really, really handy. So what I have on screen right now is just a small section of roadway. And just like just about any scanner, you see here I've got the scanner's position. And I've got some points where it couldn't shoot already. And then this is from another scan. And so you can see there's a big difference between the scan points distance between one another. So, you know, very, very close to the scan, you can see you get a very dense set of points. And obviously the set that's in the circle here is from another scanner position further away. But, you know, as I move further away and zoom into about the same level, the points are a little bit less dense. So one of the nice features and one of the nice things that you can do with CloudCompare is subsample based on a few different ways. And I'll show you two of the ways that I typically use. And what you need to do is just ensure that your point cloud is selected. So I'm going to choose roadway 1, which is this one here. And I'm going to click this icon right here, subsample point cloud. So there's three options, random, space, and octree. I've never used octree, but random and space I have. So the first one, and I think which is probably the best feature, is space. So you can specify the level or the distance between points that you want to achieve, which is great because if you have a roadway and you don't need to see, you know, all the little cracks and all the little details, then you can, you know, do something there and maybe increase, you know, instead of having every couple of millimeters, whatever it might be, go to a centimeter. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm just going to hit have a 1 centimeter spacing. And hit OK, and we'll show you the difference here in a second. This might take a little while, so I'll talk about the second thing, which is the random sampling. And it really works on the same principle, except that you choose the number of points that you want. And in that respect, sometimes it's hit and miss because you don't know exactly if you're thinning out the point too much, but at least you can try it once or twice or three times. So it looks like it's done, and you see it's created one here that says Road 1 subsampled. So I'm going to click off my main one, and now I'm going to go in and look at my 1 centimeter spacing. So when I go closer to the scan position and or further away, you can see it's a little bit more even. You don't get as much variation. So that's really nice because it can also lighten your point cloud. So if you have a very, very heavy point cloud, and you don't need that density that's close to the scanner, you can eliminate that. So I'm going to try this one more time. I have another one here. I'm just going to shut this one off. This was the original one that we worked with. So you can see that there's our copy of the original that we worked with. And you can see it's very dense. I'm going to choose something a lot higher. So let's try something like maybe, let's go to space again and try, oh, I don't know. Let's try 3 centimeter spacing. Just hit OK. And then let it do its thing. I'll press pause here and then I'll come back in a second. Okay, so it did its thing. Let me back up here and you'll see what I'm talking about. Alright, so now you can see it's gotten a lot thinner here, but still the points are even, and you know, from a distance a little bit further away, you have much, much less points. And if you just want to compare the original one that we had, let me shut off this one here, and the subsample one. So this point cloud, the original one, had almost 8 million points. The 1 centimeter, the 1 centimeter spacing or subsampling put us down to about 2.2 million. And the last one that we did, oh, that one shows me, oh, sorry, I have to go to the subsampled one, which was down here. There we go. I shut that off. And now we're down to about 375,000. So you can see you can make have a very big difference on the point cloud, and it does it relatively quickly. It doesn't take a lot of time. So I'm going to shut all these roadways off, and I'm going to bring up something else. You can also subsample a mesh. So what I have in front of me is a model that I did using photogrammetry, and so taking photos of a skull and then creating a meshed model. And this particular model is very, very dense. And if for whatever reason you wanted to get a point cloud from it, most people usually go from point cloud to mesh, but maybe there's a reason you want to go the other way for an analytical reason or something else, I don't know. But what you can do is go the other way, so you can subsample meshes, which is kind of nice. So I've got this selected here, and if I go down, actually I want to show you, let me select this one. I want to show you the wireframe because this is a very, very dense mesh. So I'm going to zoom in here and get you in to a point where you can see the mesh. It's just starting to pop up, so you go. This is very, very dense. So this is not something you typically want to work with in a regular 3D package. So you're going to need something that can handle millions of polys or millions of faces, which slows things down a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut off wireframe, and I'm going to select the object here. And you'll see that I have a, right beside the subsampling icon, there's another one called sample points on a mesh. So I'm going to click on this one. And here it says points number. So how many points do you want? Or you can choose a density. I just go with points, and I keep the default selected here. Generate normals, use or transfer the colors from the mesh, and or from the material or texture. And I'm going to go for, okay, we've got, how much is this? This looks like about 1 million points right now. So we'll subsample this. I'm going to hit OK. And it's very, very quick, actually. So it's already done that. I'm going to shut off the mesh that we had. And this is the point cloud. Now it looks a little funny. I have a feeling the normals are turned on. Yeah, they are. So I'm going to shut this off, and you'll see I've got the mesh here. And when I zoom in, it's much less dense. Again, now that it's a point cloud here, I can subsample the point cloud, and I can just do space. I haven't tried Octree, so I don't know about that. Maybe that's something for somebody else to make a tutorial on. But if I choose random. I've got about 1 million points here. I'm going to choose, I don't know, I'll choose 200,000 and hit OK and shut off the other one, and you'll see it, and you can see already that it's much, much less dense than we had before. So anyway, those are the subsampling tools. They really help to clean up a mesh if you have a lot of unnecessary points. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thanks.